So Dan,
I have a little game here. So,
okay.
Dan, you have three champions here, right? Let's say, for instance, pick a weight class, 154 or 147. What if me and Bernard would have fought at 147? Who do you think would have won?
I would have won.
I would have won.
That was your bet. Oscar was winning
because Bernard would have had to cut off one arm. To make
no, I mean, hypothetically speaking, I mean,
yeah.
You know.
But that was Oscar's weight.
Imagine if Pazienza would have fought Bernard at 154. Who do you think
would have won? Or even 160, it'd be a fun fight.
Oh, it would have been a fun fight. Imagine those type of classic fights that could have been.
Well, I'm asking about, like, you were champion at 154. You were the unified champion. You had fought some of your biggest fights in that weight class. Your fight against Fernando Vargas, one of them, of course. How would you and Canelo go down?
It would have been a draw. It would have been a draw.
That's a great promoter.
It would have been a draw.
Well, he's going to go to 160 at some point, so Bernard, have at it. You and Canelo 160.
My whole thing, first I had to beat him mentally. I'll probably do something at a press conference, Larry.
You probably throw the Mexican flag.
I don't know. No, I can't mess with the flag in Mexico. I came in. I won't get out the building, you know. But I would say with Canelo, it would be one of those fights where if he's on his game and I'm on my game, it'll go down to the wire. And I think it would be not a knockout because I never was really a knockout puncher. But I think it would be if I win that fight, it would be a fight that I'll win by decision. But it would be a well-earned decision.
So you think Canelo would be able, even if he didn't win the fight, would definitely be able to hang with Bernard the execution?
Yeah, I believe he'd hang with anybody in my era based on his style and based on how he likes to fight. Hey, listen, Canelo is boxing more than he ever did in the quarter of his career when he first started. You know, when Mayweather came straight forward, didn't know no other way, or he wasn't using them other ways, or even taught the other ways. Now you're starting to see growth and development. You're starting to see Canelo doing things that he didn't do, from what I saw, having done after the Mayweather fight, after Mayweather fight done it, but before that I didn't see it. It was just straight coming forward, Mexican style, I'm gonna hit you, I'm gonna do this. But now you're starting to see setting up with the jabs, throwing the fake jabs. Hey, Amir Khan, if anybody's seen this segment on HBO, if you didn't, you're gonna see it again before tomorrow night, if you watch it tonight or tomorrow afternoon, where I've demonstrated how he set that combination up with Amir Khan, how he made Amir Khan really focus on not getting hit in the body, which took his attention, Amir Khan's attention from protecting the face. And when every time Canelo thought about throwing a punch or threw a punch just to make him react, he left up, hands down, pushing off, and got hit with an overhand right. That's what I see in Canelo, who is starting to see a pitcher set the traps, and then once the trap is set, he catches his prey, and then he gets him out. That's what I'm starting to see more in Canelo's fights in the last year and a half.